Hello and welcome to the show. This is The Entrepreneur. My name is Paul K. Mwaura. We are glad you are watching. Like adults, kids also need good grooming. We meet a lady who has taken advantage of such an opportunity and started Rihanna Kids Spa and Salon. We're going to meet her and get to learn more from her. Hi there. How are you?
Hi Paul, welcome to Rihanna.
Thank you.
On The Entrepreneur tonight, we meet a lady whose love for children gave birth to a lucrative business venture. Diana Washeke is the owner of Rihanna Kids Salon, located along Gong Road. She has built her business around children, making them look and feel good. After working with a local airline for several years, she made the decision to draw her curtains into the corporate world and venture into entrepreneurship. She first tested the waters with an online grocery business, which she soon closed after 3 years. All hope was not lost though, given how much she loves children. She had seen a gap where they were concerned and figured that the transition from groceries to children would be the best bet.
I used to take my child to a salon, an adult salon, but I didn't get the service that I wanted there. Most of the time they didn't want to do her hair. They thought that she was fussy because she was so little. It was a strange environment for her. And eventually I had to take her to a local kind of setup, a kibanda kind of setup. So I figured, why not set up a place where kids can have fun and still get their hair done.
We all know that it takes a lot to keep children busy and entertained. Diana knew this and endeavored to ensure that her clients will never suffer boredom while at her premises.
First, the staff, they are excellent with kids. With children, you need someone who's patient, someone who will engage the child. So obviously, children don't want to sit through long hours, so we make it fun for them. We have some DVDs, some portable DVDs, so when they're getting their hair done, we put on their favorite cartoons. We have the play area where even if they want to take a break, let's say the child is tired, we allow them to take a break. We also have snacks and treats. We cook for them chips and sausage. It's a children's salon, they feel at home. Yeah, because they come and find other kids and they just gel in.
The services offered at Rihanna Kids Salon include manicures, pedicures, haircuts, and plating. Weekends are extremely busy for them as they even turn some children away.
So a haircut is 300. Plating starts from 500 all the way to 2000. Depends on what you want to do. We have manicures, pedicures that again start from 300 to about 800. We also do moms. If you bring your child, you don't need to go and get your hair done somewhere else. You can do your hair as you wait for your child. But because we are children oriented, it's more about the kids.
There's truly something magical about having an idea and going the distance to ensure it is realized.
So how much did you put into this salon? Is it from your previous employment? Is it from your online business? Or is it a loan that you took?
It's a combination of all.
All.
I had some savings. To set up the online grocery store had taken a lot of my savings. But what was left, I sold some of the assets. So what I recovered, I used to set up this salon. It was really capital intensive. My husband chipped in, yeah.
So like how much did you put in here? In approximation, maybe?
To the millions.
Here in the, for the salon?
Yeah, close to 2.5.
They say chema cha jiuza kibaya cha jitembeza. For Rihanna Kids, marketing and promoting comes through a myriad of ways.
Mostly it's by referrals. We are also actively on social media, Facebook. We hand out flyers and we have some billboards up.
No problem. After you.
When we look hard though, listen keenly enough, and feel strongly enough, the lessons are inevitable. They are all around us.
I love working with kids and I love kids. So this is something I'm happy doing. It's not like a job, it's not a chore. It is something that I'm happy doing.
Diana's love for children enables her to collaborate with her team of seven to research on the best practices and looks for them.
If I see a nice style that I think would look good on the children, first I always do it on my daughter, who's like the model, and then we put that up, and if clients like it, they will come and select the same style, probably just say the same like I saw on your Facebook page, and then we do it.
Okay.
For any business, nothing beats having a well-known brand with a great reputation. It's a surefire success. This is what Diana Washeke aspires as she focused into growing her business.
Maybe tell us, what are your short-term or medium-term or even long-term goals?
We are looking at opening new branches. That's in the medium term. Going into the bigger estates, because I mean, Kilimani is just one of the areas, but there are so many children. Like each family has what, an average of 3 kids. So there's still so much potential. And we would like to be known like the brand, the kids salon. So that's what we are trying to do.
For young and upcoming entrepreneurs, Diana sure has some words of wisdom for you.
Before you quit, be sure that this is what you want, so that even if it's not working at the moment, then you can give it time. You believe in the idea and you can grow with it. Obviously, it's not easy. You do not expect to leave employment and start making it big within the first month, but with time, it will yield.
If you just work on stuff that you like and you're passionate about, you don't have to have a master plan with how things will play out. Mark Zuckerberg, Facebook founder and CEO.
There you have it. Diana said that whatever business you want to do, let it be a business that will be for a long haul. As you think about that, we are taking a short commercial break, and we will appreciate your comment and anything that you have to tell us on The Entrepreneur. Welcome back to the show. If you're joining us, we're in the second segment of The Entrepreneur. Are you tired of unreliable, inefficient, and uninsured house cleaners? Then if you are, we shall meet a young man who has the perfect solution for your housekeeping and laundry needs. And this is Eric Otieno.
He's confident, determined, and enthusiastic about his trade. This is evident as we talk with this young entrepreneur. All he sees is clean, clean, clean. He has even taken up Safi Sana as part of his name. Eric Otieno is one of the lucky few who got into employment before graduating. This, though, did not silence the entrepreneurial spirit within him. Little did he know that the journey was to be interesting and funny.
Safi Sana is a home support service, a home support provider company. We provide housekeeping to homes and residents, commercial premises, offices, as well as industrial properties.
Eric knew starting up wasn't going to be easy, but he was determined with the help of partners to see his cleanup exercise begin. He managed to invest between 500,000 to 1 million shillings into the business.
As a startup, let me say it was not an easy process because you just don't come from nowhere and you have capital to start a business. So I actually tried to discuss with people of like-mindedness, and I met a few partners, and we together we put up resources to start a company.
Who are your clientele in these services that you do?
Our clientele are mainly expatriates, the people who visit the country for a short period of time, the people who are looking for exclusive housekeeping services, because we realize the market lacks this kind of service delivery. What we see on the streets are the ladies, they come, they sit somewhere, they're waiting for people to come and collect them, take them to the house to do laundry and maybe just wash the house. Now, not everyone is comfortable with that kind of setup. Hence, we came up with our housekeeping services, in which case we train them, we vet them, and then we groom them, and then we deliver them to you. We outsource them to you on a frequency of, like I said earlier, on a frequency of your choosing. I want to bring the five-star housekeeping from, you name it, from Hilton, Intercontinental, and I bring that service to your house.
The company has a dedicated team of between 30 to 50 that is geared at eradicating every speck of dirt in your house.
Housekeeping team is made up of, we have between 30 to 50, because some of them are casuals, and they basically come on contract basis, and then we have those that are employed by the company. So the number also varies with the time of the year. When the demand is high towards December, the numbers always shoot.
Cost for their service varies depending on the magnitude of the job. As a home support company, they are able to provide services to suit your needs as far as training your house help for you.
Now, we're in the service industry, and quantifying a service varies. And that's why most of my clients, I do advise them, let us first do a survey, and then we understand the scope of work, then we can quote. But averagely, let me say, if I'm having a housekeeper visit you once a week, the charges ranges between 9,000 shillings to 12,000.
And what services do you offer here at Safisala Home Service?
We have people calling us, they need their houses, their current house help, they want them trained. We're able to take them and to run them through our standard procedures so that they're able to deliver the quality service we offer. We have people calling us and asking if we could consult for them in terms of the kind of cleaning they want to do.
A niche can be found and established in any area of interest. At Safisana, they have seen a need to assist pregnant mothers with sanitation of their homes before the arrival of the baby, thus welcoming the bundle of joy in a spotless environment.
For the next few months, we'll be working with hospital facilities and pregnant women because we realize that certain diseases can be prevented by basically having a clean environment. We provide them cleaning services for their homes in terms of we do away with the dust, we make the home basically accommodating to the young newborn.
Eric has dreams of taking the company national, having branches in different counties.
Safisana as a company, number one, is very dynamic. And dynamic in the sense that the management team, let me say, we are the management in the mean age is about 23 years old. And this dynamic team is looking forward to conquer different areas of the country, basically by expanding our services to other regions, including Mombasa, Nakuru, as well as the marginalized regions of Kenya, the Turukana, the Marsabit areas. We want to get in there basically to provide unique services in housekeeping. We're also looking at creating employment, offering unique, rewarding employment opportunity to various young Kenyans around the country. So in the next 5 years, we're looking to be a major employer and a major player in the housekeeping sector, as well as introduce other services, including an online platform.
You being a young person, what advice would you give to young people out there who are listening to you and want to get into entrepreneurship?
I have to say that entrepreneurship is not an easy journey, and it's not something you can do alone. You will need a mentor. I personally have a mentor who's taken me through the phases, he's coached me, he's guided me, he's provided me the necessary advice I required when I needed it, and it is what has helped us get to where we are right now as a company.
There you have it from Eric. They have all the services they offer here at Safisana Homes. So, I hope you learned something. My question to you is, how clean is your house? Good question. As you think about it, write to us on our social media pages that are on your screen right now, Facebook, Twitter, and our email address. Thank you for keeping us company. Till next week, same time, same place, same channel. See you then. I've been your presenter, Paul K. Mwaura. From the team and I, it is good night and God bless you.